Hello and welcome you all to our show, The Style Icon. Today, we have with us a beautiful lady who hails from Jaipur and is now the face of Mysore. So let's welcome our own Jayanthi Ballal to our show.
Hello, Namaskara.
A lady who started her journey with two sewing machines, and she now owns a modeling school and most importantly, a pioneer of Mysore Fashion Week. When did you first hold a needle in your hand?
When I was doing my designing, 19 years ago.
19 years ago, what? You were like in 20s then?
I was 20s,
yeah.
Once I started, I'm a graduate from Oak College, that is in Bangalore. Though I live in Mysore, I heard Oak is a good institute those days. So I joined. I had the options for JD and Oak. Then I joined Oak.
Okay. So you knew that fashion is where you are excited in and where you wanted your career to be.
No, actually when I joined the designing, it was nothing like I'm going to go further like this. After doing designing, then the college owner, it was a very small college, it was like one-to-one, we knew all of them, the students. So the college principal, come owner, whatever said and done, his name is Karyapa, I still remember. He's from Coog. He was telling Jayanthi, he used to tell me in Mysore Ali, you should do this, you should do that. And basically you should do an intern under some designer, that is what he kept telling me. But as it is, like, you know, we had a lot of problems, like women has a lot of problems, you know, when you can't do intern. Then I had a responsibilities of taking care of my family. I just did my designing. I wanted to get back to Mysore. I lived a year in Bangalore. I did my designing. Then I thought, like, overall, once I'm prepared for it, then I'll come and do an intern.
Mm-hmm.
So that is how my journey started.
Yes. What is the first lesson to be a designer?
Hard work. Actually, I feel most of the designers really work hard. It's because the creativity and the competition, what they have to live up to the designs equipped to the society, till the mark. You know, they have to come to that level. I said, okay, now you design something which is outdated. I said, what's wrong with her? Why is she designing this? So this is not at all in. So everybody has to live up to the mark. Creativity is there, hard working is there, dedication is a must.
Anybody who has passion for fashion can be a designer as far.
Yes.
Yeah?
If the three qualities is there, hard working, dedication and creativity is there, anybody can become a designer. It's just this, a course, you know. I'll tell you one thing, is certificate.
Mm-hmm.
Doesn't matter much actually. After doing the designing, I'm like, this is a basic thing they teach you. They say, okay, this neck is called the name of the neck, the pattern, all those things they teach you. But probably these days colleges are doing much better.
Better, yeah.
So once they are out of, probably like 19 years ago, there was not much.
Nothing much.
Yeah, nothing much. But these days the colleges are teaching a lot. So there's MBA in designing now. So there's MBA in a lot of things. So
but do you think that's important?
Actually, I feel practical knowledge is more important than the theoretical. See, later on, you have to get into practical norms.
Yeah.
See, practical, the paper cutting and the cloth cutting is totally different.
Mm-hmm.
You can do any design in papers, sketches, in anything. But when it comes to practical, it is very, very
difficult. Very difficult.
Very different and very difficult.
But won't they stress too much on practical in the course?
They do have, but it's not, I guess these days I have no idea of the college what they are teaching now, but we have intern students who's under me. But when they say, no ma'am, we were not taught this, see, that is how they come up with their options. But during our time is only paper. They would tell us, okay, sew this, sew that, and all those things. We would get the fabric and say it was compulsion that we have to do all those things practically.
Practically.
But when it got into theories, it was totally different. Practical, theoretical is totally different. But I faced a lot of problems. But then again, trial and error, as usual, you get a fabric, okay, this is not fitting in the straight cut. Okay, then you give a different cut, give a curly cut, give this. So we would do it in like trial and error basis at times.
Yeah, I think technology also plays a major role in this. Now everybody is like gadget freak. You see a design, you try to do it, but compared to your days, the practicality and the practical touch for in any business or any art, I'm saying, practicality is more important, which people are losing out these days, right?
See, that is what everybody does. After your designing is done, you get into intern with some designer. See, now I am a traditional designer. If your forte is a traditional, then you get into me. Like, you want to do intern, like, you know, how do you take an order, including taking a client's order, then draw it, like, you know, which is the work, they draw. Then what is the inch of the work? Okay, fine, draw. Then whether it is cups. So there are a lot of things they learn once they get into intern.
Intern.
So when they learn, it's generally like a year course. However, it depends on them. If they want Western touch, they go to Western designers. If they want to get into a traditional forte, they come to traditional designers. That is how it is.
We've heard struggles that models face. Is it the same with designers also?
The same. Actually, models, I think they face 20% of the struggle. Designers has to face more. You know, once when as a designer, my garment has to go on a model. So first you choose a model, a right proportionate model. Then, like, you know, what looks good. See, my garment has to look good on her.
Yeah.
So make it designed like that. Okay, her, the characteristics, like, you know, what is her height, like on which garment, which color, all those things a designer face a lot. Investment, a designer has a whole lot of investment. She does it. She has to, see, if she wants to exhibit on a model, she has to pay the model, she has to pay the makeup, then get it on the shoot. Okay, if you want to just put it on social sites, just do a shoot. Or else if you want to get it them on a ramp, then production, lighting. See, designers face a lot of problems. See, if you want to be an established designer, doesn't happen just overnight.
Yeah.
You need to really struggle a lot. Struggle a lot in the sense you want to make it big. That is there. It's not easy.
It's not at all easy. So first, you make the design, you conceptualize the design, and then search for models, and then we go
see,
through the process.
What happens is I start working for my collection. See, now I'll take an example of Mysore Fashion Week. I start working for my collection from 6 months. 6 months I work on the collection, and then when it's close by, 45 days prior, we start blocking the models. So we take the models, and it's all like, you know, we take an height, we have the criteria. Height should be minimum 5'7", and the minute we book a model, their measurements are sent to us, sent to all the designers. When it comes to fashion week, we send it to all the designers, the measurements. So then 5'7 is minimum, and their vital statistics is like, you know, so much. And we would know, they send their pictures also, mean that. See, there are a lot of models, we wouldn't have seen them at all. Mm. They just send their pictures and portfolios, they look so different. In natural, they are, you can't make out. So we generally, what we do is like tell them to send their actual pictures, measurements, and then we go. Now it's social media is there, you just go.
Very easy.
Go check their natural pictures, then you book them, then you take them. That is how we do.
How was it before?
Model choosing is not really difficult. Once your collection is nice, of course, see, our collection should look good. That is what all the designers expect, and even I expect the same thing. So it was easier for me to pull on Mysore Fashion Week because as a designer, I wanted the quality of the model to be good. So model also face equal challenges, but designer faces more challenges, I feel. Yeah, investment wise, choosing model wise, production wise, everything. We face a lot of challenges.
How does it feel to lead a fashion week?
As a designer, I think I was a chilled out designer. I would like, it's been 19 years I'm a designer. It was not that difficult for me to design. I would like, you know, get like, you know, the minute I see a garment, I would say, okay, this is what I can design or not. I would do it so easily. But being an entrepreneur, it's very, very difficult. I said Mysore Fashion Week is the most challenging job I'm doing. It started like very coolly. It was in 2013. I did Fashion Extravaganza for 2 days. Thinking like, you know, let me try something for Mysoreans. I did for 2 days. I said, it is a nice event. Let me go ahead. Did for 2 days and everybody said, wow, this was in Mysore lifetime. yeah. Mysore history le it's not done. The way they speak is a Mysore history le agila itra event. I said okay, something I'm setting
small
a trend.
Small town, yeah. People are not used to.
So I thought I'm setting a trend actually. Then couple of friends from Bangalore who used to coordinate with models, they said, why don't you register Mysore Fashion Week? I said, is it? What is that called? No, you have to have a TM rights.
Oh.
I said, oh.
So you didn't know?
I didn't
like
know.
Like you didn't think in those terms at all?
I wouldn't actually, because I was a chilled out designer, to be very honest. I run my boutique from 14 years in Mysore called Needleworks. But I'm the chill out designers. I said, whatever suits you, I would give you ideas. Like, see, designers being friends, it's a different thing because that can happen only in tier 2 cities. Not probably metropolitan cities, but tier 2 cities, you're more friendly. You're more into, they invite you for the family functions. They invite you for the cocktails. Or like, you chill out, like more socialized. That's how your business happens.
Yeah.
So I registered the firm. I said, okay, let me start. I thought it was like easy as like fashion extravaganza, what I did for 2 days. It's going to be the same. But I didn't know there's something called backstage managers, there's something called backstage people. I said, oh, I never knew it's going to be that tough.
Yeah.
Then we wanted to get big designers and we wanted to get supermodels from Bombay. I said, how do we do that? I said, I didn't know how to do it. I stay in tier 2 cities. Though I was like frequent traveler to Bombay, Calcutta and all, I didn't know how to book. Because they had their own rules and regulations. A model who's coming from Bombay, they are tied up with agencies. And the agency would tell us who is free for those days. So I said, then what do we do? I said, okay, chalo, we'll try. Through some source, like, you know, we got hold of some 10 supermodels, like Diana, Parvati and all, like, we could get them through. And we were 10 supermodels. We set the stage and it was a Carlson group, country in, we did the first time. I'm like, after the event, I was just thinking, did we pull this event on? And we see the videos, we felt, oh, look like Lakme kind.
Yeah.
So the setup, Rocky S was the finale designer. We had like 9 celebrities, Priyamani, Mugdha Godse, Gauhar Khan, and Rocky S, Aslam Khan designers. We
the
were
best
big.
In the industry.
The best it happened. Mysore, they said, this is quality. This what we expect Mysoreans. Because see, they are from the royal family.
Yeah.
Every second person in Mysore is well off. They are rich. But they don't know where to spend, how to spend. Now, it's like, you know, when it comes to...
have it
to,
in the same city.
That is what. So now they say, everything comes to Mysore now. Why should we go out?
Go anywhere.
Earlier, it was like, you know, for even, I mean, for any entertainment, they would come to Bangalore.
Yeah.
Now, say they're chilled out. They wait for Mysore Fashion Week. They say, when is the date? You've not announced the dates. We don't want to go anywhere. We don't want to travel out that time because we can't miss. So this time when Ravina Tandon walked for me, everybody say, oh, we had crush when we were youngsters. So it's just like that. We set the trend. When Soha Ali Khan came last year, my theme was Royal Runway. So we wanted somebody from the royal family. So they were like, oh, that's so nice. You like relate so much for Mysore. I'm doing something for Mysore, as Mysore has been lacked all this while. I would want to do more, but I need support.
I think government should work on initiatives like this, which tier 2 cities trying to come
actually,
up.
Actually, that is what even I felt. The government should encourage. You know, Rajasthan government is encouraging Prasad Bidappa does the event over there in Rajasthan, every now and then in the palace. But here, there's no support. From the government, there's no support at all. I said, who asked you to do? That's one thing. Like, you know, I said,
instead of appreciating.
Yeah, we don't have that fashion culture at all. We never wanted Mysore to be there. But they say, okay.
And what is it that you're portraying? It's South Indian culture.
I said, there's nothing like, you know, it's wrong. Now, when they talk, okay, you put Mysore on the fashion map. Okay, where we couldn't get to see, we see this kind of events now. There's a lot of things they appreciate. But when it comes to term of supporting, they don't.
They don't. They back out.
They back out. That is that one thing is like, you know, I would refer.
Yeah.
And this tourism thing, Mysore is more tourism. Anybody who comes to Karnataka,
they have to visit Mysore.
Mysore Palace is so famous, Brindavan, Chamundi, everything.
KRS, there's so many things
to
see in Mysore.
Is. So I feel it's neglected, total neglect.
A lot of struggles. We see Fashion Week as something amazing, it's mind-blowing. But the struggles that designers and Fashion Week owners, I mean, they go through.
See, generally, one thing I would like to tell is Fashion Weeks is not owned by a single person. It's owned by companies.
Company.
Like Lakme, Maybelline, FDC. They have their group.
Group.
Wherein I am like single person. Mm. That is where I think I'm facing a lot of
problems. Issues, yeah.
I would definitely want to make a board or just get one company tie-up soon so that my work is little reduced.
Is it somewhere because you're a women entrepreneur?
Yeah. Actually, yes. People take you very lightly. Like in the sense, oh, women, what she can
take you for granted.
See, in the sense, to first 2 years, I had to make a platform to tell them, this is not the other fashion week where it's going to wound up like soon. I had to set an example saying, okay, no, this is going to go on
ongoing
yearly basis.
Thing, yeah.
Because there are a lot of fashion weeks which is closed down. There's closed down. They said, we don't trust. One woman is holding. You know, I went to a sponsor of said, I say, one woman is holding this fashion week. Dimag theek nahi hai. I said, this is what they said. Why? What happened? Arey, aaj to mood ban gaya. You made it. I said, kal mood nahi bana, you'll close it. I said, what is this? How can you do this?
You got to hear all these.
Yeah, all the things. All the things, you believe it or not. I said, how can I close a fashion week like that? I said, a lot of fashion weeks are shut. A lot of fashion week is shut. I said, how do we trust you? I said, see, every fashion week shouldn't be like the other fashion week. The person behind that who's like dedicated, I said, I'm an entrepreneur. I said, I have a good name in Mysore. I said, I can't do that.
Not just in Mysore, it's entire Karnataka. In fact, India.
So, but that is what I get the feedbacks.
Very difficult.
Very difficult to handle these kind of people.
So overall, it has a lot of pros and cons.
Yeah, the lots.
Lots. How do you manage your time across work and family? Do a lot of things.
doing a lot of things now. It's very difficult. Actually, to be very honest, it's the toughest thing. Mm. If I am giving time for my children, then my work is neglected.
And two kids,
yeah, yeah. Two boys.
Yeah.
And when I am giving time to my boutique, it's like my children are neglected. When I am giving time to my children, my work is neglected. It is very difficult. It's because when it comes with, as a designer, I was managing. As a designer, I was managing as a mom, as a housewife, everything. But after doing this events like Mysore Fashion Week, that is the time I'm finding it very tough because I need to travel a lot and my timing is so weird. At times I come so late, I wouldn't even see my children for like days. My husband is a very supporting role. So he sends them to school and though whatever said and done, mom is a mom, so I feel very guilty. At least I want to get up in the morning, which is not possible. See, whenever I can balance it, I said, okay, this is my kid's day. So that's how I'm balancing these
balancing
days.
Somehow.
Somehow.
Takes a lot.
It is very difficult, but somehow managing. Like, okay, probably on the weekends. Shut my phone, okay, say, okay, this day is for y'all. Okay, we'll go out. Something like that we've been doing. But luckily, they are intelligent children. They're doing on their own.
On their own.
Somewhere
the
here.
Blessing.
Blessing, yeah. Blessing probably. Because I'm doing for something for the city.
Yeah.
So they are good. They are good on the studies. So not much that I have. Unless until really required, I give them attention.
So you are able to manage everything,
yeah.
Some or the other way.
Some of that. Mysore is, it's not so much traffic, to be very honest. It's everything is like 20 minutes away. So it's
easier.
To manage, yeah.
From your JB modeling school, you've expanded to offer formal fashion, choreography, training, cosmetic, makeup. And
see, all I started was in 2010, giving a platform for the localites. Though after my second son, I had almost 2 years, the boutique was on and off. Like once I got back to the events, how I got back to the events in the sense, I wanted to relaunch it. It's because after he was a little ill when he was born. So 2-3 years I took off from my work. Then when I wanted to get back, I found it like too much competition. Suddenly I felt I was lost. Though I'm a designer since 19 years, I was running a boutique, though everything was there. But to get back, you know, the trend, to catch up the trend and everything, I was very like I didn't know where I was lost. Then to get back, I thought, okay, why don't we do something called model hunt? So model hunt, we just put it on Facebook. That is a new trend on Facebook.
Facebook.
That time, 2010 when I enrolled, that's the time I have my account. So we said, okay, whoever is interested in modeling can approach. And Infosys had a, what is a training institute. Like, you know, they train, the trainers, a lot of trainers. So we put an ad, like, you know, one of my friend was working. We just put it on bulletin board saying, okay, who's interested. So we had a lot of applications. I said, okay, fine. One, we have a like gang of four friends. One friend said, okay, I'll do the grooming, I'll do the choreography, and I was a designer. So it's all started like that. And probably I'm too much a commitment kind. Everybody after one stage, they moved. Say, Mysore, you're not paid and your work is not recognized. But I was very dedicated. I said, I don't start anything. If I start, I continue to do it. Whatever it is, I am a person like very much like,
yeah,
you know,
people who made fun of you, like,
yeah, that
when
is
you started Mysore Fashion Week and you're able to do it like for 4 years continuously.
For 4 years, so when 2010 we did so the first time model hunt, so media was so happy. I said, oh, something to Mysore a woman is doing, who's I have a family name too, the Ballal matters in Mysore. You come to Mysore and ask for Ballal circle, my family is so famous. And somebody from that thing, and the girls will be safe. See, the first thing came to their mind was, will our daughters be safe?
Safe.
So one lady out of a good family, that mattered a lot for me there. They said, oh, lady from a reputed family, she can take care of the daughters.
Daughter.
That's where they started sending. We have the whole course, like 45 days. We train for fitness. It's everything done free of cost. We show them how to do the makeup, party etiquette and everything, like, you know, what a model needs. Just that we didn't get top quality. We would say, oh, even 5'3 height would good. But as it is in a fashion week, minimum height is 5'7. See, some who's made it up to 5'6 also, we give them a chance for Mysore Fashion Week. But wherein, if they're less than 5'6, the other designers wouldn't want. So it's like that. We would launch them, we would send them to Bangalore, print ads, we would tell them there is an opening. Y'all can go. Some are doing serials now. Some are doing print ads. Some went to IMC, Shilpa Singh, who I launched her in long back, like 2010 or 11. She went to IMC, but she couldn't be a part of it. And as a model who was a face of Mysore Fashion Week, she made it to, she was Miss India. She represented Miss Universe, Nayanita Lohan. There are a lot of people, you know, they've come, they say, okay, after coming to Mysore, we've been blessed with Chamundi.
On what basis do you choose a showstopper?
Showstopper is, see, basically I'm traditional designer. So it has to be like something who can carry my sari well. No, sari is a different scene actually. For me, I started with the redoing the old saris. I used to do the sari, then I would look at it. I said, this looks nice for the broader shoulder. The pallu has to be big like this. So when I create a sari, it's already done. But I look for the celebrities in the last days. My sari is done like about 1.5 months ago. But I'll be thinking who's the best, who's the best. Then we look into PR. We look into PR, then we'll ask the best deal, what they can give and who can relate. They'll give an options. Then out of those options, we choose one person. But when it was Royal Runway theme was given, I was very particular from the royal family, that Sohalika. But she was in London. She had to cancel 2 times the ticket and then again rebook it.
Wow.
She said, Jayanthi, I'm just coming for you because you have done the whole Dasara in the sari. She said, you have that runway thing, Royal Runway. Yeah. And I believe she belongs to that royal family. So she said, because you told me so much, I'm coming. It was delayed a little bit, but we could pull on a successful time that time also.
How do you choose a fabric and a pattern for a client?
Generally, what happens is, like, you know, I'm traditional Kanjivaram in the sense everybody is stuck, okay? The blouses has to be like this. So these days, what I've done is I'm doing contemporary blouses. I do like net mix and match, brocade mix and match, all those things I'm doing mix and match. And I had an article about that in Times also. in 2014 when I did my first fashion week, I had, it is called a checks cut work. The minute of my fashion week got over, the next day I could see on Facebook 10 people, their cover pic was a blouse. I was like shocked. I said, I don't put my label.
The striped one you're saying?
Checks cut, like the like block kinds of blouse. It's a pink blouse. I was like, you know, I said, it's my blouse or we've got it. Like, you know, something like it was too. So it was, whoever was there, they were like shocked to see like Kanjivaram can be worn in contemporary ways also. So I choose, like, you know, anything what I like. To be very honest, there's nothing called I have to be in the trend. Whatever I choose, I'll think, that is why I told you, I take 6 months to do my collection. I sometimes, it's like one or two gets flopped also. I do some weird combinations.
Trial and error.
Trial and error. And I'll see, okay, this is not okay place. So, so do something. That is what, like, you know, we generally, it's like Kanjivaram in the sense, they say, okay, Kanjivaram has to be worn like that. But these days we are breaking that monotony, saying, okay, no, you have to wear, you're not
supposed to. More exciting, right?
I feel like, you know, when my collection is getting ready, I feel, okay, this piece is going to get sold first.
Because you'll yourself feel that.
Feel like, you know, see, the I'm doing a lot of Kanjivarams. Yes, of course. It's like, you know, what happens is Kanjivaram comes with blouse pieces. And generally what happens is once the blouse is spoiled, it's gone. So we take a different blouse and like
again
do it. So to get matched with that silk, it's very, very difficult. So at times it's like you have to take a risk. And at times I do a langa blouse with out of the kanji, I do it. Last time we did to match that pallu and the, to make a skirt, it was very difficult task. So we had to literally match with a dupatta and something we did, and but it turned out to be very well. It was JK's picture on board, and Jackie Chetty, Jackie Bestovich, and another four girls standing in front of the, we shoot every year, we shoot, you know. So that time we had to do out of Kanjivaram only, I did everything. So because that is my forte, so I didn't want it to go out of the box. It's not like designer can't do anything, we can do everything. So, but I wanted to do everything in Kanjivaram. This time also, Shubhra Ayappa, she wore a Kanjivaram long dress.
Okay.
So, the contemporary touch is
this
there.
Was in Fashion Week?
Yeah, we do the face off.
Okay.
We do the shoot. So, that time we give the, all this contemporary, we try over there. Trial and error, like, you know, we did. We did a skirt, we did a blouse, and we did a long skirt out of a sari.
Do you have any plans to come up with a collection of something like that for your upcoming fashion
week?
Yeah,
I want to do the short skirts, but I don't know how Mysoreans will take it. So probably out of city, I don't mind doing it. Again, it is a...
So not for Mysore Fashion Week is what you're saying?
Yeah, not for Mysore Fashion Week. Probably one of the solo show. But it's a huge investment as Kanjivaram is too expensive and you break a sari and do it in short skirts, and you need to have a client to buy also. See, in that aspect,
so you can work on order basis and not for fashion week.
Fashion weeks, yeah, that is not. But again, order, you can't mess it up. So it's very difficult. But I'm doing a lot of contemporary blouses these days. Like earlier, I would do is redo the whole old sari and make a new blouse for them. But later on, like, you know, once they started, I used to get clients from Dubai, from Chennai, from Malaysia. The lot of clients would, like, you know, get their old saris when they got married. They would get the saris. I said, can you do something for it? I said, we would redo it and courier it to them. So it was like, they, it was quite famous in, I'm talking about, say, it was in 2002, 2003.
Oh, back then.
Back then. So doing a lot when I started the boutique.
It means a lot for a woman, for a girl, the wedding sari and everything.
See, you will not, you can't wear them. Say, they say they outgrow the blouse. First of all, they outgrow the blouse after they married.
Get married.
Doing up the sari again, a blouse, it's a little difficult.
Yeah, matching all that
and do that. That was my forte. I used to redo the old saris and give that. But unknowingly, I got into traditional attire because I've tried in chiffons, I've tried in Banaras, everything I've tried. But Kanjivaram, it's like it was a hit kind.
If you are given an opportunity to design a costume for Sonia Gandhi, what would it be?
I would give a Kanjivaram. I think Sonia Gandhi is more into cottons.
Cottons.
I was just thinking, like, you know, what to give her.
Probably. But not letting your forte go.
Forte go.
Yeah.
Probably that boat neck blouses for her.
Yeah. She'll be more comfortable.
More comfortable. And those lightweight kanjivarams are in now. So probably give her like dull colors what she wears and the covered neck. So try to put one here like little glittery, but you don't act, I guess. But Sonia Gandhi, yes, it's not a difficult task because cotton people wouldn't get into silk. Let me be very honest with you. They are so comfortable in cotton, they don't want to get into silk.
What was your first creation?
My first creation. There was a family function, and this is the time I was married also. And my mother-in-law, like, she gave me an old sari. Those days they used to say, okay, chinna irate, belli irate, all the borders.
So, no, that's true somewhere.
Sometime, like, you know, she used to tell that, but it was her wedding sari or something like that, she said. So she gave me a sari. I made a halter neck top and a long skirt, and I didn't dare to wear in front of her.
And she had given you this.
She had given me. I said, but still I have that collection, so I've kept it. I said, this is the first creation of mine. I said, I don't want to give it. And the next was like a net fabric. My husband used to own a CD shop. He had got it between the glasses to put up those net fabric.
Okay.
Out of that, I made again one skirt. So the initial days, I would do only like waist fabrics. You know, I didn't want to try out with something new. And
so when you're trying,
I was very careful when it comes to, because I come from a very very ordinary middle class background family. So in our family, like, you know, nothing called wasting. So I would be more careful when I was in the designing terms also. So probably that added on, like, not me investing too much, and I want to do something very different. But now it's different. You have no choice. But these initial days was like too much on the waste fabric.
But what made you choose ethnic as your forte?
I think without knowing, I got into the traditional, as a traditional design without knowing myself. Because earlier as a designer in Mysore, they would come only for salwars. More of them would come for salwars, and I told you, they would get their old saris and they wanted me to do the blouse. Wherein I was dead against saris. I wouldn't wear sari at all.
God, are you serious?
Yes, that's what I would do. My mother-in-law's sari tear, do that langa blouse, do this, do all kanjivaram, but do, I mean, all that, the contemporary ones. But then recent, like probably from the time I started Model Hunt, so my forte is like cholis. I would redo that sari and the blouse for the clients, but I wouldn't wear it. Once I started wearing chiffons with brocade blouses and other things, I felt like, you know, it's the right time, like, you know, I do. Because my blouses fit with perfect. My master was so good. Any design I give him, it was like that. But from a long time, I was doing tradition on and off. Just that without knowing, I got into total forte of like traditional.
Traditional.
Yeah.
So it just happened.
Yeah, it's happened. Like, no, nothing like, this is your forte, this is my forte.
Do you feel you have any competition in the this fashion industry?
Competition is there in every field, actually. It's not like competitive in prizes. And probably the same design, they might copy and do it in the lesser price. It's generally, like, you know, there are a lot of people who copies also design and make it for the lesser price. It's probably like who can't afford Manish Malhotra. They go for a look-alike Manish Malhotra. Sabyasachi, they can't afford. They go look-alike Sabyasachi. It's like there, everywhere it is there. But see, here I thank media because my design's been highlighted well. My design's been highlighted well. Probably from, I come from a, like, you know, different scenario, like suddenly I made it big, and I keeping tradition in mind, keeping culture in mind, I have done design. Probably that is how I've been recognized. See, it's not like, you know, I'm not creative. Yes, of course I'm creative, and I have to create a dasara thing on a sari.
Needs
a lot of things. Yeah. 22 days, eight workers work on it. Every bit has to go on it, and this time it's a palace. Like, again with that, I said, you lose, like, you know, day and night. I said, this is not that. This is not done. So you keep doing it. Creativity also matters. But here, I feel I'm being blessed.
Because it's like history on the sari.
History on the sari, palace on the sari, it mattered a lot. And the minute people saw it was like, they were saying, oh God, this is too good.
Super
a creativity.
Good.
And her sari was sold first. That's what, like, no, the minute a celebrity wears. See, there was no traditional designers who made it big. Probably there are in Hyderabad, as it is, I told you, taking only that as a forte. See, you should stick to your forte now. I started with salwars, lehengas, that, this and all. And suddenly when I got into the limelight, I've said my forte is traditional. Especially sarees and my blouses. The minute people say, okay, Jayanthi Ballal, her blouses are amazing. See, that is how they relate. So it is probably I stuck to
now
it.
Now with the contemporary blouses.
Yeah, now though it's more of like, you know, people will be waiting. What's the new thing she's going to do? So they'll wait one blouse, two blouse. It should be something very different. That's what they wait for.
No, my checkpoint is you. Whenever I have to get a blouse done, okay, Jayanthi Ballal, what's it? I check the blouse.
Oh, that's really nice. I'm honored actually. And I would like to, like, you know, a lot of people who's there, I would like to tell them, like, you know, don't throw away the old saris. You get a new blouse done. It is like, you know, you can wear them again and again. It's like the blouse can be worn for other saris. I'm like, see, cost effective.
Yeah.
Creativity should be there as cost effective. Also. Yeah, that's what we do.
Do you have a role model? All-time role model?
In a designing field, I have, like, you know, when I started, once I'm done with my designing, I was like, looked for, like, Ritu Berry. I would like to feel, oh, Ritu Berry is like one fashion icon, the way she dresses up, the way she carries herself, and I guess
so that still remains.
Yeah, yet I can't change. My role models can never change. I still like her the way she is. That is what it is for me.
Nowadays, there's a lot of kids also started wearing designer outfits. Do you have any plans of making the kids walk the ramp for you in the future?
I really want to do one thing is super moms, because the mothers who's juggling between work, family and all those things. One is that I want to respect those ladies who really doing all such things. And then yes, kids, of course, kids can never be neglected. Kids, they make our life really joyful. So probably in future, I wouldn't mind doing something for kids also, kids of Mysore and kids of Karnataka. So somewhere I wouldn't mind. But I would write, first I want to do super moms.
Super
like,
mom.
You know, moms.
That's an amazing concept.
I want to do super moms. Because
be a better platform than Mysore Fashion Week for
yes.
this?
So because the way they juggle their life, the way they the work, family, kids and all, but they balance. I know what I go through. That's
and
what I
actually, you should be the showstopper for that.
No,
Best example.
I want to do up the event and I want to recognize that those mothers who are really working harder than me. Yeah, true.
What are the three essentials in a woman's wardrobe when it comes to ethnic?
Ethnic essentials. I think one black blouse.
One black blouse and you can match anything.
Anything, yeah. One black blouse with common gold work so that you match it with everything. That's what I feel, yeah.
What is the silk that explains Jayanthi Ballal, that one silk? There are so many forms of silk, right?
Yeah, there are varieties of silk. Actually, these days, my cholis are highlighted well. See, now people, the minute they look at, oh, this is Jayanthi Ballal's creation. Okay. That is what my thing. The minute they see my finish and the loops, see, we have a kind of finishing product. We are not left abrupt. See, when the woman is a designer, she looks into it, each and everything, you know, detailing, minute detailing. The loops which is tied at the back of the choli and the kuchu, the sari edges, everything is looked into it, everything is customized. So we give each and everybody the same importance like that. See, I feel, you know, every bit, the minute somebody sees the sari, okay, did you get it from Needleworks? They can
like
make
that.
Out. In Mysore, it's been there, but I have to set a totally different set for outside, like, you know, outside Mysore. The minute in a function you go wearing my collection, they can make out that it is my collection. Yeah. Because the perfect thing what we give. Whatever said and done, I'll never let my tailor go till they give the finishing So I am too like focused in the finishing thing.
So keen on that.
Yes.
Do you have any message for YTV viewers?
Thank you for watching my show.
Thanks a ton for being on our show and sharing your journey in fashion industry with us.
Thank you so much.
We wish you a lot of luck for your upcoming projects and your future endeavors. And we hope to see you as an ethnic brand ambassador for Karnataka.
My God, blessed to hear that. Actually, I would love to do it.
Yeah.
Yes, it's because I'm representing Mysore now. I said I want to do it for Karnataka too. Hopefully, my journey is easier in future. I had a tough time all this while. Might be it's much easier in future.
Thanks again.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for watching the show. This is Nikki signing off. We'll be back with the next episode of Style Icon. Bye.